Now we will learn specimen study of Balanoglossus and Botrylus. Aim of this practical is specimen study of Balanoglossus and Botrylus. First, we will learn about Balanoglossus. Now we will discuss the systemic position of Balanoglossus. This is included in phylum Chordata. The characteristics of Chordata are, first, these are aquatic, aerial or terrestrial. Second, their bodies are small to large and bilaterally symmetrical. Third is, they have paired pharyngeal slits present on either side of the pharynx. Fourth is, they have a dorsal tubular nerve cord and notochord. Fifth is, they have a post-anal tail, that is, an extension of the body past the anal opening. Subphylum is Hemichordata. The characteristics of this subphylum are, first, their bodies are soft, worm-like and divisible into anterior proboscis, middle collar and posterior trunk. Second, they have intraepidermal nervous system. Third is, sexes are separate. Class is Anteroneusta. The characteristics of this class are, first, presence of numerous paired pharyngeal gill slits but no gills. Second is, gut is straight. Third is, the trunk is irregularly ringed. Genus is Balanoglossus. The characteristics of this genus are, first, they are solitary, burrowing, worm-like animals. Second, they have short and long proboscis, long trunk and ring-like collar. Third is, two rows of hepatic cecae present in the middle of the body. Fourth is, terminal mouth and anus. Habit and habitat of Balanoglossus. Balanoglossus is a tubular or burrowing and exclusively marine animal. It is found in shallow waters between tide marks along the coast of warm and temperate oceans. It is worldwide in distribution. Balanoglossus has about 20 species. Some comments on this specimen are as follows. 1. Shape, size and coloration. The body of Balanoglossus is soft, elongated, cylindrical, bilaterally symmetrical, ciliated and covered with mucus. The length varies from 2 cm to 2.5 meters according to species. Most of the species forms are drab colored, though reddish tints are present. Many species are luminescent due to mucus. They have an offensive odor. 2. Division of body. The body is unsegmented and divided into three regions like proboscis or protozoom, collar or mesosome and trunk or metazoome. First is proboscis. The proboscis forms anterior part of the body. It is either rounded or conical in shape with hollow and thick muscular layer. It is continued posteriorly into a short, narrow neck or proboscis stalk, which is attached with the collar. Its cavity, that is the proboscis coelom, opens to outside by a small opening called proboscis pore. Second is collar. The collar lies posterior to the proboscis and anterior to the trunk. It is very small and lies behind the proboscis. Third is trunk. The remaining part of the body is cylindrical and tapering towards the posterior end, and it is known as the trunk. The trunk is divisible into three parts: an anterior branchiogenital region, a middle hepatic region, and a posterior abdominal or post-hepatic region. On the dorsal side of the anterior region is present a branchial groove in which are present a double row of gill slits or branchial pores. On the sides of this region, genital ridges are present. The whole of this region is called branchiogenital region. Behind this, hepatic cecae are present on either side. The abdominal region is longest and cylindrical. It tapers gradually and has a terminal anus. 3. The mouth is situated behind the proboscis. 4. The roof of the buccal cavity gives rise to a small, hollow, stiff, tube-like outgrowth called the buccal diverticulum, which is supposed to be the notochord. 5. The nervous system is simple. 6. Sense organs are absent. 7. Sexes are separate. 8. This shows external fertilization. 9. Development may be direct or indirect with the Ternaria larva. Now, we will discuss the second specimen, that is Botrylus. First, we will go through the systemic position of Botrylus. This is included in phylum Chordata. The characteristics of Chordata are: 1. These are aquatic, aerial or terrestrial. 2. Their bodies are small to large, bilaterally symmetrical, metamerically segmented. 3. They have paired pharyngeal slits present on either side of the pharynx. 4. They have a dorsal tubular nerve cord and notochord. Group is Protochordata. The characteristics of this group are as follows. First, it includes lowly organized chordates. Second, cranium, true jaws, paired appendages and vertebral column are absent. 3. They are all marine, fixed, burrowing or free moving forms. Subphylum is Urochordata. The characteristics of Urochordata subphylum are as follows. First, they are exclusively marine and cosmopolitan, commonly known as sea squirts. 2. These are solitary or colonial. 3. These are fixed or free swimming and pelagic. 4. Body is covered by a test or tunic. 5. Nervous system is well developed in larva, reduced in adults. 6. Notochord is absent in adults. 7. Numerous gill slits are present. 8. Sexes are united. Class is Acidiaceae. The characteristics of this class are as follows. First, these are fixed or free swimming marine forms. 2. They are simple or compound, solitary or colonial. 3. Their larvae are better developed than adult. 4. They have numerous gill slits. Genus is Botrylus. Habit and habitat of Botrylus. Botrylus is widely distributed in the Atlantic and the Mediterranean, being found fixed to wharfs, piers and ships in shallow water. Some comments on this specimen are as follows. First is, it is a colonial ascidian. Second, the colony consists of a gelatinous mass with individuals or zooids grouped together in radiating star-shaped, that is, arranged round a common cloacal opening. Third, the atrial apertures of the zooids open into the common cloacal opening. Four, the oral apertures open on the outer ends. Five, the structure of the zooids resembles that of simple zooids of ascidians. 6. The nerve ganglion is situated ventral to the neural gland. 7. The stigmata are rectangular. 8. Reproduction is asexual or sexual. 9. Asexual reproduction takes place by budding. Summary. In this topic, we have discussed about the systemic position, habit and habitat, and general characteristics of Balanoglossus and Botrylus. Balanoglossus is the most familiar hemichordate genus, belongs to class Enteroneusta, which has a straight digestive tube with mouth and anus at opposite ends. They have numerous gill clefts but have no anus. They are burrowing animals ranging in size from about 2 to 50 centimeters. As we read Botrylus, it belongs to class Ascidiaceae. It is a colonial ascidian with star-shaped radiation. Due to presence of all above characters, the above species are known as Balanoglossus and Botrylus respectively. Thank you.